Welcome back to part 4 of my haunted house dark ride, and I have to say this episode's probably the best one yet because you get to see more or less how the ride is sort of going to look. And as you can see, I've already started making some other rooms that will be part of the house. They sort of look connected, sort of from the back, but they're actually not, they're actually separate. I think if I was going to make this build in the future, I would have actually tried to make the ride go inside the actual house, but I'm not sure if it was too feasible without having some ugly track going in there and this and that. So there is some extra house added on, and as of yet I still haven't quite finished with that part. I think another few hours it will be done, but I'm really not quite sure what to do in that part. I think I should make a bedroom in one of them. That room that you see right there is gonna have has a fireplace in it and is lit up in green. You know, all the inside interiors, I think I'm sort of lighting them in green, and the hell scenes and stuff are going to be lit in red. So as you can see, behind everything is, as you can see here, I'm starting to make a wall going around the track, and in that semicircle will be a graveyard, and it's probably my favorite part of the whole ride at the moment because it just looks like how I want it. I'm struggling a bit with some aspects of consistency with ideas. I don't want to repeat myself too much, and I'm afraid I might be doing that with the Kraken a bit. I think there's just too many Krakens and too many tentacles, but all in all, I don't have a lot of stuff to work with or that will quite work with this ride, so I'm just trying to keep the landscaping and things like that a bit more interesting. There's going to be a bridge inside hell and this kind of stuff that I'm working on, and I hopefully you'll get to see some of that during the video, but if not, that will be in the next video. So I'm just using this Control D cheat to get the walls looking pretty curved, and I have to say, I'm quite pleased with how curved they look, and I think I should have been using this technique a lot more in my other builds. I think many of my designs are very square and very boring, so that is something I should really work on. And I'm also using rocks to sort of separate the tracks a bit so you can't tell you're in the same area. That's generally how I think dark rides operate, but I could be wrong sometimes. It depends on the level of expense, I guess, that's put into them, and far too many are not really well thought out, so you know. So I'm just placing some sort of ferns and sort of trees and making it all overgrown and making these little environments and this kind of thing, and adding lighting in the end. I think in this episode you also get to see a bit more of the construction of hell, and I'm very pleased with the way the hillside with the trees worked out. You can sort of barely feel like you're going uphill, you know. It doesn't feel so much like it's an uphill battle. I think I have to cover it a bit more with trees and maybe some more weeping willow like effects and this kind of thing, and you know, just more trees and more detailing. I mean, it gets a bit difficult to talk about constant detailing because there's only so much I can actually say, like, oh, there's a bit of detailing happening here. Well, now you can see I'm actually making the gravestones, and this is something that I enjoyed the most, actually. It was a bit tricky getting them in the right positions, and I'm just using the sort of rocks to level them into the right positions, but from behind, those windows look exactly like gravestones, and they make me very satisfied. They do, I have to say. Using some trimming for the house to make a sort of grave-like thing, and I'm going to cover it with plants so it looks overgrown. But all in all, it's coming together. It's coming together, and I love these little statues and these kind of things. I think the mermaid statue is actually quite creepy, regardless of, you know, if you really light it, you know, with the right lighting, it actually doesn't look very. It looks quite sinister and these kind of things. So. And I realized that I could use this skull as the entrance to my hell mouth, and I really, really think that looks sweet, and especially once it's lit up in red. It really gives that, oh, don't come here, you're going to hell kind of look to it, so, yeah. But, you know, all in all, also that grass looks great for overgrowth. So I'm also, all in all, I'm quite pleased. I think I'm going to make another little graveyard in the front garden. But I don't know, I have to see once the ride is done. I don't want to repeat myself too much, and I already feel I'm repeating myself way too much. But, you know, this game is not, you know, released. It's only got one thing to play with, so I'm just doing my best, you know. I'm not so talented, though. I can't do, like, everything I want. So it's just about learning. I'm just learning still with this game. I think I've been learning it since I started playing it. And I don't think I can look back now. I think, you know, I was gonna upload some City Skyline let's builds, you know, I love City Skylines, and I was gonna make it next, and then I just like, no, I'm too addicted to this game. I really was surprised by that. I really didn't expect to love this game that much that I would literally rather play it than draw, which is, you know, I should be working and doing some drawings, but I would rather make a fictional theme park, you know, because that's something I've probably always wanted to do in real life, was to design theme parks and these kind of things. So, as I said before, I am so hooked, and I think nearly everyone I've seen online who's playing this game is also incredibly hooked. So I think that's a huge merit to the creators, and I think they've done such a fantastic job, and I can't imagine this game not existing because they've literally spent so much time on it, and I'm just counting the days for the update to come. I think it's coming in May. And terraforming, yes, I can do so much more now with the terraforming, and hopefully water will get added, but I haven't heard about water, just about the terraforming and the roller coasters, but roller coasters have already come, so I'm not super excited to have roller coasters since there already are roller coasters. But all in all, I'm very, very happy. So now I'm making the room, and I really would like some input and to tell me what you guys think about this, because it was a huge piece of experimentation. Like, I really, you know, trying to use the tools in ways that are not conventional, and that's not really my strong point. I tend to like to use them conventionally, and I think that's the problem. So this is a fireplace, and I couldn't find anything for the fire, so it's just lit with red in the end. But tell me what you guys think, if you think it's sort of getting there. I mean, this is what I see other people do with their Let's Builds. They make stuff completely unconventional, and it's completely off the hook crazy, man. So that's what I was inspired by, and that's what I've been trying to go for with the fireplace. You know, I would much rather have a sort of grandfather clock in that position, but you know, this game, why would it have a grandfather clock? So yeah, and some candles, maybe some sort of like candlesticks and these kind of things, and some portraits. I tried to think about putting posters and stuff up, but ugh, it looks disgusting. So all in all, I'm just sort of looking for ways to make the inside look like inside, but you know, it can't look perfect, and you know, it doesn't matter yet because it's not finished. I don't know what else to put in there. I tried to put some benches and sort of a seating area, but I didn't like the way it looked. It just didn't look good, and maybe I will come back to it and try to figure out a way to incorporate some sort of pictures and this and that into it. But all in all, I think I'm severely limited by this sort of technique. You know, I don't feel super confident with it, but you know. But maybe the more I do it, the better I'll become. And that is the important thing. It's just practice, I assume. But I haven't seen anyone try to attempt to make sort of indoor furniture yet. And I think, so I don't have a lot of ideas. I've just been playing around with some of my own, but maybe I don't feel these ideas are strong enough. But it's definitely fun to experiment. And so this is part, I think this part you see from the road, from behind the house. So I thought, you know, it has to look like it's sort of joined to the house. And I think it sort of feels that way when you're on the ride. It sort of feels like you're in the middle of the house. But yeah, actually, no, it's completely isolated from the house. I hope soon I move on to the hell part, because that's actually a bit more interesting. I think in parts of this video, I start to make the hell part. Once I am done with this room. But at the moment, I'm just adding more and more windows and more detailing, and that for me is 90% of what I find fun. Detailing, just pushing it further, you know, adding layers upon layers. I mean, sometimes you spend hours doing detailing and you come back and you're like, oh, that looks crap. But I think generally it looks better than less detailing. If you spend hardly any time on something and then, you know, you come back and you're like, well, I could add this and this and this. I think that's, you know, generally better. All in all, I have no idea what I'm talking about right now. So I'm just hoping I will move on to the hell part, because that would be more interesting to talk about. Nope, more windows. I seem to just want to add more windows, more of my favorite things to do. Windows, 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 windows. Okay, I'm still, I think I'm gonna cut this until I come back and start making the hell part. Now it's time for my favorite part, well, many parts of my favorite part, but the lighting, because lighting just makes this game that extra awesome. And green for creepy effects and red for also menacing evil effects. That's what I've learned about color schemes and lighting, is that they really make or break effects. And the green just looks so spooky. It just looks like, woo. And I lit that building up in white because it wasn't specifically supposed to look creepy just yet, you know. And I'm definitely having to use a lot of red lighting inside the hell scene. And as you can see here, it's the hell scene. Only partially completed in this part, I might add. There's a lot more that I've added since filming this. And it's coming along quite slowly. I mean, in the last episode I had said it would take... It's about 45% completed. Well, I've been working on it for about 4 hours today, and I still think it's about 45% completed. So don't hold your breath anytime soon of having this finished, but I am working hard to make sure it happens. And as you can see, I'm lighting up the Kraken in red. That looks way more demonic and awesome, I think. So it seems to be working out okay. And I also realized I didn't put any lighting inside the building, so I was struggling with the camera to make sure it was at least lit up a bit. I don't know what to do with that viewing area. There should theoretically be a room or something there, or a stables or something. But I'm still not sure. I think I might just fit it with, like, barrels and stuff like that, you know. Pirate theme is a bit, like, limiting. But yeah, you know, all in all, it's not so bad. Some green and red lighting to keep it all creepy. Lighting up the back of the building in green to add it a bit more spooky. It looks a bit more haunted. And adding, you know, some detailing to that part of the building. I think lighting is incredibly important. I don't know. I think if this lighting didn't exist, the game would be, like, way less immersive. And these games have to be immersive. They really do. Otherwise, they are not fun for me to play. Immersion is the key for simulation games. And... Well, not necessarily, but for me it is. It's all about making semi-realistic or inspired by real-life things, because that's what I feel proud of when I've done them. I feel like I've really put a lot of good effort into it instead of just, you know, making it a bit half-assed and this and that. So, you know, I try. I try to make it good. I don't know what you guys think about it, but I try to make it as well as I can, because it's great enjoyment for me. You know, I try to push it further and further and see exactly what everyone else is doing and try and, you know, develop on that and get it, you know, better and better. And, you know, that is the idea, I think, but I don't know. So I think I'm gonna leave it there, and I will see you in the next episode, where you'll see more and more of the ride being built, and you'll get a better understanding of how it will look. And I have to say, I'm not sure whether I'll make a walkthrough in that episode, or if I'll make a completely different episode of just the walkthrough that you can watch afterwards. I still haven't decided yet, so maybe you can tell me what you would prefer. You know, leave me a comment. No, make it part of the video. Oh no, you're gonna make it separate, whoop-de-doo. So yeah, just do that, because I am only listening to what other people say half the time, because I'm new to this whole video game making stuff thingy. So if you have any tips and tricks and blah blah blah, please let me know. Because I appreciate input a lot. I really do. It helps me a lot, I have to say. I don't like getting stuck, and I'm getting a bit stuck at the moment, because I'm finding not very easy to think of stuff to do with this. It's way too big and way too much going on. So, I will see you in the next episode. Please tune in for that.
Thank you.